Welcome back, everyone! I know you miss us so much. We're gonna keep playing SOMA. I still don't know what it stands for.
We haven't started the recording, though, so it's
the audio, right?
Yeah, it's the audio.
It doesn't matter.
Okay. Did I interrupt you in that?
No.
Okay.
You don't want to say something to the people? Smooth as silk. Anyway, I guess we're gonna try to get out of that weird room where we were reading a bunch of poetry. Death poetry. Those emails?
Yeah, I remember.
So last time we killed some robots. One of them wasn't really a robot. I think neither of them probably were. I think the first one was probably a person too.
And we ran from another one.
Yes. Although, I don't know, he still looks like animalistic to me. So it's more like a weird ostrich, you know? Like a giant bird. Oh, look, he tells us exactly what's happened. So they could talk again. Yeah, she's not very friendly, though. Somehow I don't think that this is going to help us that much, because if it was going to help us, the game would be over faster. I feel like she's just going to, like, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Maybe. Someday.
If it ever decides to load.
Press any button to continue. You fool!
I think I have my headphones on backwards.
Double fool. So what does the dome of ceiling have to do with anything?
That's just how she described it.
Oh. Alrighty.
Where's the button?
Okay. What does that mean? That never works. Come on. Partial data. Successful! So happy.
Josie has me back on the lock.
We got everything we need to move. But we can't leave the plant without supervision. Adam's decided to leave Amy, Asaro, and Kalsanka to execute the automatization process.
I wanted to introduce you to Amy and Cal. They'll be doing the talking as soon as I leave for Theta. Say hello.
Hey, Theta.
Hello.
Direct links are almost impossible to establish. The Lumar relays are basically junk at this point. You can send messages via the comm center, and if you want, I'm pretty much always here, ready to relay anything by hand. I know it's a shitty system, but it's all that works right now.
Alright. Well, I was gonna talk shit about you to her, but I guess I can't if you're gonna be the one relaying, you know. It's just an elaborate scheme to keep you from talking shit about him.
I just want to tell you that I'm gonna seal the comm center now, so this is definitely the last you'll hear from us.
Okay, good. I'll rally the troops for a welcome party.
None of this makes sense. Does this make sense to you? What is happening? What does this tell us?
I assume that's just them evacuating. Like they were talking about.
Evacuating this place? They seem, like, too chill about it.
I think they're evacuating from here to... I think they were, like, shutting this place down. It's like, gradually... Oh.
Chaotic neutral. What was that? Is that a minigame?
Yeah, that, I had to move it. It's weird.
I like it.
Oh, that's better. Simon, was it?
Simon Jared. Where do you even begin? I mean, what is this place? How did I get here? And why do the robots talk like they're people?
Well, you're at Epsilon, clearly. Have you never been there before? Where did you work?
The Grimoire in Toronto. Is that really important?
No, I mean, where did you work at Pathos 2?
I don't know what that is.
Is she real?
This is all so strange.
You're telling me.
Simon, come to Lambda!
How do I get there?
Well,
that doesn't help. Well, time to go swimming, I guess.
Shit, where do I...
This guy's a good actor. I like the voice. This woman is, like, weirdly helpful. Why does she, like... What is so great over at Lambda that she's like, oh, you're talking to crazy robots? Just come chill with me. We're totally fine over here. And this doesn't confuse me at all. Swim!
I think they did say something about, like, leaving the crazy robots behind. That did not happen in that time.
Well, that's the thing. I think that's the...
What the hell? How is this possible?
This isn't... We're
insane.
In a diving suit.
You know what?
I think we've been here for, like, 30 years or something.
Oh, that's cool, though.
That is super cool. Oh my god, it's awesome. But yeah, I mean, like, the stuff going over the thing... That's gotta be, like, a sign that a bunch of time has passed, right?
Maybe. What?
What were you gonna say?
It's difficult for me to say stuff because like, I know a lot of what's going on, and so it's like...
Oh, you do know what's going on? Okay, well then don't tell me, because I don't know what's going on. I'm just gonna speculate.
I wasn't gonna, like, tell you, but I was thinking of how to, like...
Well, if you can think of how to do whatever it is you're thinking of doing, let me know. But if you can't, then I still don't want to know. Okay, better safe than sorry, because this is really intriguing.
Huh.
Man, this is awesome! So, basically what happened is you blacked out, and then some little fairies put you in a suit, and they saved your life, like the little, like the cobbler and the elves making the shoes all night. But it took them like 30 years to do it. And now you're a robot, I guess, maybe? I don't know. This is awesome. I love underwater crap. When you don't have to worry about, death. Death by drowning. It's like being on the moon.
Zeppelin transport.
A zeppelin? Why would you need a zeppelin underwater? That seems like the most counterintuitive thing.
That looks like a flea or something.
That's what I thought said looked like a water bear. A tardigrade. I guess it doesn't really look that... It does look more like a flea, but... For some reason, I thought it looked like...
Just stand in the circle.
Whoa, it's like a chalk circle. Like a demon summoning circle.
It's a sea bear circle.
Oh my god, you're right. It totally is. Oh my... Holy shit. That's totally a sea bear circle. Well, not at least you know you're now you're safe from sea bears.
Safe. But I must venture out.
I guess so.
Because I have no idea where I'm going.
Really? I thought you knew what was going on.
I know what's going on. I don't know all the stuff though.
Okay. We're gonna find Atlantis, right? That would be cool. I'd kind of ruin it actually. If we had to, if all of a sudden it became like completely fantasy about an underwater city with mermaids and crap or something. I'd be like, well, okay.
It'd be cool if it was like old and abandoned, like the ancient city that was like sunken and like the mer people weren't really mer people, they were more like mer creatures.
Wait, what? What about that? What?
I think that'd be more cool. Like,
oh yeah. Scientists
stumbled upon it.
I would want a game that was about that, not about, like, because this so far seems like it's not. If there was a game about creepy Atlantis,
should
that'd
I
be rad.
Look this way first.
I don't know. Data buffer.
Come in, Zeta. You better answer me, Strasky. Come on!
Amy, where are you?
The field. I had to leave.
Is Carl with you?
It all went to hell.
Hold on. You got the power automated, right? The plant is safe. We need the power to keep the sites running.
Oh, fuck the power!
Wait. What happened? Did you go too far away from it?
I don't think so.
Why did it start?
Should I try again?
Yeah, sure. Just stay next to it.
Come in, Zeta. You better answer me, Strasky. Come on!
I'm trying to figure out the names of the people.
Fields. I had to leave.
Is Carl with you?
It all went to hell.
Hold on. You got the power automated, right? The plant is safe.
Stop
the
moving!
Power to keep the sites running.
Oh, fuck the power! Fuck you, Strasky! The machines killed Carl.
Aw, oh, shit. All right, calm down. It'll be okay. Can you get back to Zeta?
Yes. I think so. I'll head for the shuttle, the
Ox. Good luck, Amy.
Everyone's, like, weirdly chill at weird times. You know? Like...
Seems that way. He killed Carl. Okay, just...
Yeah, it's gonna be okay. It's like, well, obviously it's not, because Carl's dead. Well, he wasn't dead, really, but then we killed him, so... Whoa!
Hi.
What is it?
I don't
it's
know.
Talking. Oh, it's so...
You're talking to me? Should I interact with it?
It's not attacking you. Greedy?
Yeah, but I'm also not in its light, I don't think. Hi.
What does he need? What is it? What is that thing? It looks like got a face like one of those monkeys with the big noses.
I'm trying to look at it.
A little what? Meth? Heroin? What the hell? Maybe this was
time to go. Okay, yeah, no, I'm not supposed to. I'm supposed to run from this guy.
How do you know? Cause he's creepy. Where are you going?
It's threatening me.
I guess, but why are you? What is happening? You're making me so nervous.
I don't know where I'm going. I might have walked into a dead end, and I might have to jump up here.
Is it still coming? I bet it is.
I'm sure. I just don't think it.
Don't go back.
I think it went the wrong way. There are two ways to go, and I think this way's a dead end.
Go. I'm scared of it.
Still back there.
I know, but keep moving. Keep moving. Get away from it. I don't like it. I would honestly. Why wouldn't they just like swim to the surface? Like, I feel like it would take a million years, but.
That's a good point, actually.
Wouldn't you want to know? I don't know. I guess now that I think about it, once you're up there, what do? You just hang out? I guess being down here is probably the best.
At least these, like, automatic lights still work.
Yeah, interesting. Although I don't know if I like that because it means that we're easy to spot. What is this? What is this?
Don't know. My vision's getting funny. Oh, maybe because of that. Hi.
I think it's trying to get in there.
I probably shouldn't mess with him.
No, definitely don't. Get away. Go.
Like, okay, what is that over there?
What is what?
The big light.
I think it's just like another, like, it's like a Grand Central Station kind of thing, I think, right?
Maybe. Something's moving.
Do you think they're all trying to get, like, power, like, from that, like, that one thing that was like, I need it? Our creepy camera bot. Mangled camera bot. Like that guy who was like, I need it. They're all just like addicted to bioluminescent power crap.
Apparently, where am I going?
I have no idea. It made me really nervous.
No, I'm just wondering if I can get up there. Like, can I climb up there?
How am I supposed to know?
Am I supposed to interact with this thing? Did I just pass this thing by?
I have no idea.
I'm not asking you. I'm thinking out loud. I'm sorry.
I just don't know. I wish you would do something.
I'm trying to figure out what to do. Okay, finally.
This looks like something. Yeah.
Finally making progress.
Yeah. Okay. How do we turn on the damn power?
Oh.
Or maybe you just need to, like, scrape the barnacles off of it? Minigame.
Right. How do I do?
I don't know. We work at a comic book store.
It's true. We'll start doing stuff.
Are we supposed to... Do we just have to move them around or something?
Maybe. Oops. That's not the way I wanted to move.
Or maybe we can't.
Or maybe I'm just disabling it.
Oh, maybe. Maybe you're disabling the lock.
Okay. Oh. I'm not rewiring anything. I'm just tearing it apart.
You're just tearing out the...
When in doubt, just pull out all the pieces.
That's funny. The open... I like how you click the open button still. Like... Access granted.
Thank you.
Oh, is it draining?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's airlocked. Thank you, AI helper Jane.
Let's hope the shuttle still works.
See, that one opened.
I mean, if so, we just have a long trek, right? That's a very good question.
I was about
question.
To ask the same thing.
Well, I figured it was on your Omni-tool. I feel like this isn't our body.
Strasky, I'm at the shuttle, but it's not looking good. I have to fix it. I don't want to get stranded halfway to Theta.
I think we're astral... Don't tell me if I'm wrong or right, but I think we're, like, astral projecting into someone else's memories or, like, not memories, but, like, their life. Like, the person that... Simon's brain is in right now, had a flashlight, and was doing something before Simon showed up. Mm-hmm. Like, he just, like, skipped forward in time. And, like...
Sorry, I'm, like, fascinated by this thing.
By what thing? The...
The water falling in that way.
Oh.
Like, why?
I didn't know that. I thought you were just waiting to hear my amazing, speculation.
Well, that too, but...
Insufficient power.
Should I interact with this first?
I mean, yeah, I guess. Maybe that'll...
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't glowing like the other one.
Jesus Christ! What the hell?
I can't believe the strange thing if we would do that.
It's a male one! It's a male version of that creature or something.
Okay.
I thought that it would, like, give you power.
Exactly.
Something. Also, what the hell was the point of that?
Don't know.
I still don't really understand the point of those things.
I think those things heal you.
Yeah, but that certainly didn't, did it?
I'm at full health, so.
Oh. Whoa! Someone did a lot of digging. It's very spooky.
It is.
Whoa! There's a man!
Oh. Hello.
There's a woman!
Hey, are you?
Don't hurt me!
Can I help?
It won't let me die. Nothing is allowed to die.
What?
What happened?
An accident. Fixing the power. I was going to Theta.
Anything I can do?
If you see Masters or Holland, tell them I need help. Okay?
Why can't I help?
I can't talk to her anymore.
That's so weird.
I'm really scared to pull cables now.
This is really confusing.
Haha.
What are you gonna do? Smash it?
I don't know.
What if he just, like, sprayed it on her? And she was like, what are you doing? He's like, I don't know. I thought it would help. What is... So there's, like, some giant sentient thing, like, in Halo, right? Like the whatever. Grave robber. Grave digger. And it's infecting everyone, and nobody can die because they need all of their bodies, their bodily fluids. But it's, like, the underwater version of Gravedigger. Gravedigger! Sunday!
I mean, should I do this?
I mean, I think you have to, right? No?
Are you okay?
Did she die? She's blinking.
Are you okay?
I don't know. I want to go home.
Why did she say no? She just said it's not gonna let her die, right?
I think she wanted help. I don't think there's help to give her.
No, I know, but why would she even say it doesn't allow you to die?
I mean, what did you think was gonna happen? Oh.
I'm very confused. Why did she even say, it won't let me die, nothing is allowed to die, if she didn't want to die? I don't get it.
That is really confusing. Now.
Well, whatever, she was not being clear or helpful. She was not like, don't do that or I'll die. She was just like, I don't know, I'm very confused and I'm sorry for her, but...
I got a lot of mixed signals from what she was saying.
Yeah, me too, that's what I'm saying. She didn't like say what she want. Like, I don't know, I don't get it.
It sounded like she wanted me to do her a mercy and kill her, but...
Yeah, that's what it seemed like. And then she was like, no! And you're like, what?
Okay, well, now that she's not...
This is, like, not the first time that this has been confusing.
Oh, this is the shuttle.
The difference between mercy and, saving them? Like, everyone is confusing about this. But you know, Amy, you were no help, so, every man for himself, screw you. That's what I say.
Oh.
Maybe they'll come back to bite me in the ass.
This is, like, a cargo one. I think this is the one I'm supposed to get in.
You're just gonna be a hobo. You're gonna ride the rails.
And over here. I don't know.
I don't know,
man.
Let's
just go.
Shuttle J6 activated. Proceed to the nearest
exit.
Ah,
oh,
if only it was J5.
Oh, I can't. I have to sit here. Okay. I was gonna, like, crouch to make it look like I was sitting.
That's funny.
Oh. I hit buttons. Hit all the buttons. Oh.
This makes everything easier.
You are here. So where did she say she was?
Lambda, right?
I mean, it's the next place. We may as well go.
So I thought it was in Theta, but then I was wrong. Right? Remember I said Theta? I think it's Lambda, right?
Well, we're going.
Whee!
Oh, God.
What, we're going fast?
Yeah.
Welcome to Pathos 2, your expressway to the stars.
The stars? Aren't we underwater?
Operation in the 60s. Has now become home to the Omega Space Gun, the world's most affordable way to launch satellites and deep space probes. Our
Is
unique Atlantic
so?
Ocean location allows for this gigantic coil gun, running longer than a marathon, to safely launch projectiles without risk of damaging the payload with risky combustion. The station has multiple sites and has a diverse staff of engineers and scientists. Together, they are able to produce, assemble, and launch the world's most sophisticated spacecrafts. In addition to our principal operation, Pathos 2 is also the home for multiple research projects within the marine sciences, in including hydroculture, turbulence, and deep sea construction. We are now leaving Upsilon for Lambda. Lambda is Paphos 2's shipping dock and transportation hub. There, you will be able to find shuttle trains leading to all the other parts of the station.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, we have to sit here for another 47 seconds, it looks like, so... Oh, good. Maybe stop then?
The ETA said, like, only 40 seconds. So, we should be able to walk the rest of the way? Like...
I mean, yeah. Like, we were going really fast. But, like, probably only took, like...
40 seconds? We weren't going like, that fast. Like, it wasn't, like, speed of light.
15 minutes. Not a bad walk. Maybe. I don't know.
I think it sounds like not a bad walk at all. Wow.
Convenient.
Yeah, I think it's just time to walk, you know? I'm walking. Yes, indeed, I'm talking.
This all feels very, Dead Space.
Well, that's, one of the reasons I think that, interesting.
Hello.
Is that Amy?
Simon, are you there?
Catherine, is that you? I was on my way, but then the shuttle train, it fucking crashed.
Are you alright? Says the section is sealed for suspected hull breach.
How'd you know I was
no,
here?
I'm not all right.
Because,
what the hell happened
because
to the
it
world?
Said track construction. Somebody would know. I think.
Wow, you're really out of place, aren't you? Look, don't worry about that right now. I realize you're confused, but you're so close to Lambda. If you just keep going.
How close? Can I walk there?
Yeah, but the tunnel is locked off to protect the overall structure from collapsing. What you need to find is your section's maintenance hatch. It'll lead outside.
Maintenance hatch. No problem.
What's going on up there? I gotta go. See you soon, Simon.
I don't. I think that a map of
Catherine?
The, like, it would
okay.
show that there was a crash in that area. She probably called the phone in that area.
Gotcha.
But or she might be a figment of his imagination or something, you know. But I'm just saying, if there's, as far as reasonable explanations go, I think there is one. Cause that's probably why phones like that are even there, right? Like, so that if there's a problem, somebody can see it and contact them.
Hope this opens the door.
I think this is bad. I think the more you do this, the more you get, like, sucked into this hive mind.
Oh, I think I found it.
Found what?
The maintenance hatch.
Well, I guess
actually,
you gotta get out then, don't you?
I think that's the thing to, like, prevent the tunnel from collapsing that you're talking about, but I don't know where to go. I didn't see it in the door.
I don't know. I feel like you should stop touching those things.
Okay.
I think that's, like, a bad... I think you're gonna get addicted to the same thing that everything else is addicted to. I mean, you do know more about this than I do, but... What are you listening for?
I thought I heard something inside that door.
What if you turned on the closed captions and it was like, monster coming your way, like, and you knew, like, maintenance hatch leaking, so you knew exactly what it was.
Ominous footsteps.
Yeah, exactly. To the left or right, probably?
That's what I was looking for.
It's gotta be around here somewhere, go slower. Look and listen. What's that say? Nope, it's just in Chinese, okay. I think it's Chinese, I didn't look. I'm pretty sure it's Chinese. Look, there's something to the right.
This is what we talked to her on.
Oh, you're right.
I went really far back.
Well, there's a light blinking. To the left. Exit.
So exit. Stage left.
Right you are. Good spot.
Sometimes backseat driving works. I don't think you need to close it.
I know.
Although, then, if you don't close it, it might fill up the whole tunnel with water, which seems like... Oh, it closed itself. Yeah, there you go. Now look up.
Oh.
Why were you not?
I just got impaled by a ladder. I didn't notice the thing open. I was totally expecting the thing in front of us to open.
No, I saw it on the ceiling. It's like that thing that is on the top of every school bus.
Gotcha.
So that if it gets sunk in water... Kids can go up the top. I always used to think that was, like, a real danger. Like, that someday we would have to use all the emergency stuff.
I can fly Lambda, right? I mean, really? How big can this ocean be?
Just follow the truck. Can you tell where the...
Yeah, I think I'm supposed to go this way.
Backwards?
No, I was there.
Oh, okay. I like that, though. How big can this ocean be? That was very charming.
That's...
It was funny.
I don't know how to respond to that. I should be running. And maybe I shouldn't be, but I'm going to be.
Why not? You want to attract attention? Or do you think because
probably.
Simon's a nerd and he can't run that fast?
No, just attracting attention. I don't care. This is how I get through scary games. I just run headfirst into danger.
Uh-oh. Get out of there.
Unless you have to sign that this thing is here to kill me, is that my stuff distorts?
Why do they want you? Why are you not running away from it? Why are you not running? Why aren't you
I'm
running?
I'm trying to lead around this thing.
That's stupid. You're obviously faster than it. Just run. You stupid, stupid man. You're gonna get yourself killed. That's another lambda. Oh yeah, I remember because lambda is the half-life symbol, they said. And something.
Yeah.
This is it, right?
What is that over there?
I don't know, but it's just green, and green so far has been our friend. Right?
Fair enough.
This must be Lambda. Or Catherine.
That just, like, clips through the thing. That's the top of the door. It's, like...
What are you talking about?
It didn't go up through, like...
Like a
gap? Hole.
What? Well, who cares?
I just think it's funny.
I don't think there's anything in that box.
It's like Carthage, which is...
Your name?
Yes.
It's a dress...
Oh,
that's... What? 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 What just happened?
Who was that?
That's not Catherine.
I assume that's another monster. One way or the other.
Well, what? Hey, don't go so fast. There's, like, windows. What's in those windows? Don't
look. Oh, that's her. She's telling me not to look at the thingy.
Not look at what?
The monster, probably.
Well, then where are you going? What's happening? Don't look at it. Don't look at it. What does that mean? Don't look at it! Stop looking at it!
I don't think it's there anymore. I think it went in a side thing. So I need to get around it. Somehow. Or I'm going to die, and this is a terrible idea.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you walking in the dark? Where are you going?
Anywhere, I'm trying to make progress.
This is not where Catherine is! Follow her voice! Follow her voice!
Didn't think about it that way.
I don't think that she's a human.
Can I close the door, please?
Where is she?
Hey.
Hi.
I'm here.
No, not you too. I was really hoping you were human.
Don't let the circuitry fool you. I was human once.
Can't take any more. This is... Everything's fucked. I give up. There's nothing left.
Calm down. It's not the end of the world.
I like her a lot.
Sure? It sure as hell looks like it. For all I know, there's no one left except for me.
What do you mean? I'm right here.
Don't take this the wrong way, but I meant any humans left except for me.
Have you looked at yourself lately? You're a walking, talking diving suit with some electronics slapped on for good measure.
I don't.
You don't want to think about it? We'll start thinking about it.
I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to be this. I want out.
Before you do anything hasty, could you help me with something?
I like her. I want her to be our new buddy.
I was trying to find out what happened with my project when that brute knocked me to the ground.
Your project? How could anything possibly matter when you know you're a stupid robot in a stupid dead world?
Hey!
Okay, focus. I need you to fix me so I can get back to work. Then you can sulk as much as you want.
You gotta be kidding, right? I think I have a better chance of building myself a time machine than of putting you back together.
I don't think that's
I
true.
I just need to access the computer. Oh, is that an Omnitool you're carrying?
Oh, the door opener?
The door opener!
That's one where I woke up.
That'll have to do. Plug it into the terminal.
Sure, whatever.
I like her. I like her a lot. Why is he being so mean to her?
I don't know.
When the Omnitool is loaded, just plug my Cortex chip into the tool.
She's adapted so well to this.
It will be obvious. I'll eject it for you. Just grab the chip and slide it into the Omnitool. Come on, I just
do it! Why aren't you doing it?
I'm waiting for her to go through all the dialogue.
Lambda Terminal 27.
L. Murin.
The Omnitool is ready now. Should be easy enough. Just pick up the chip and slide it into the Omnitool.
Right.
Why does a robot chip fit a door opener?
It's standardized connect.
Catherine? All right. Let's give this a try.
Yeah, what do you mean? Well, don't ask so many stupid questions. Why does a robot chip fit a... Who cares?
Custom Cortex chip found. Shutting down helper chain.
Is she going to be your new buddy?
Just pretty much anything will fit. Oh, this feels weird. I'm in the Omnitool. Thanks.
So, what's the project about?
My project? Oh, well, I saved all the people on the station as brain scans and put them into
she did it!
World. We were going to launch it into space to save it from, all of this.
Are you telling me that you were going to launch a computer world filled with people into space?
Yes. It was just a pet project at first, but it got really serious after the comet took out the surface. Then, suddenly, it became very important, and it was officially named the Ark.
That's appropriate. How far did you get?
I don't know. That version of me that I am. It came from a scan I did pretty early on. The living Catherine could very well have finished the project and launched it. I guess she could even still be alive. Weird thought.
So the talking robots, are they also scans you did?
They could be, but I doubt it. I'd expect much more sense if that was the case. All right, finally.
What's happening?
I managed to restore some data from the backup server. This should tell us everything we need.
Everything?
Oh. Could you do me a favor and run into the other room and have a look? I don't seem to be able to view the files in this condition. I need to know that the Ark is safe.
Sure, Kath.
Thanks. I'll unlock the door for you.
I like we have a friend. I hope she doesn't die.
What was I said before? Are you from Toronto?
Yeah, I just went in for a brain scan and suddenly here I am.
That doesn't make any sense. How? Why would anyone bring a scan from Toronto?
You think that's strange? What if I tell you it was back in 2015?
Whoa.
What year is it now?
I don't know. 2077? Are you pumped for the new Cyberpunk game? Because I am.
Can't make any sense of it.
You say something?
Sorry, still trying to figure out how you got here.
You got it. I'd really like to know who thought sending a Canadian to the bottom of the sea was a good idea.
I like Simon's view of himself.
Just check the computer.
Yes, look for anything about the Ark.
It said data recovered Ark, so I assume... Opinion poll.
Huh.
Are you excited about the Ark?
At first, I couldn't really see the point of it. But then I thought, why shouldn't we, right? I mean, if we are able to save even just a small piece of ourselves, why wouldn't we do that?
So you are in favor of that?
I think it's really important we do this.
I don't know about that.
What are your thoughts on the Ark?
It's a great idea. Finally, we have something to do. Am I right?
Are you optimistic about the project's chances of, about the Ark reaching space?
Is Catherine asking these questions?
It can definitely be done.
I think so.
You already solved the biggest problem, how to actually get us all in there. Now all we have to do is build the damn thing. And Hope Fi is still operational. Yeah, I think we can do it. But it's not gonna be easy.
I don't know, this seems like a perversion of humanity.
That's the point, Sergeant.
What are your thoughts on the Ark project?
Like, maybe we should just all die. Throw a huge party. Party like it's 1999.
By every definition. It really makes you think about what it means to be human.
What makes you say that?
Beyond the basics, beyond the superficial, I'm convinced there's something with even greater value. You have provided a platform, which is not necessarily restricted to our digital progeny, but a means of actual survival.
Is it though?
It's my sincerest belief that we can go on living through the reality of continuity.
What does that mean?
I don't think it means jack shit. I think he's just an egghead.
Is this from inside the Ark?
Yes. That's some early renders of the world inside.
Looks a whole lot comfier than this place.
It's not real. Actually, I don't mind the idea of a fake world like the Matrix. That's fine with me. But the idea of a bunch of, like, scans of your personality, like in, San Junipero in Black Mirror. That's like, San Junipero seems like it is more directly you. But just a scan of yourself is like, okay, I guess. Like I would participate in this, but I wouldn't like work hard on it. I mean, it is something to do, I guess. That guy was right about that. It just seems like a weird thing to be like, this is so important. Like, well, you're gonna die anyway, dude. Everyone dies someday. We're all gonna move on to the next world, and why is that one red?
I don't know.
I think 3 might be us.
Oh, it was... Oh, this is selected. I guess default to I feel normal.
I think everybody kind of feels normal. They're all like, oh, I just feel normal. Yeah. Like, I'm not saying... Don't answer it the way that everybody else does.
Well, I mean, I kind of feel like... Don't I seem like myself? About as much as anything else?
I don't think... Sure, you take the test. You take the test the way you want to, man.
Sure, normal.
You're underwater and you keep changing your, like, who you are from year to year, but sure, you're normal. You're definitely normal.
More sensitive. I feel like I'm experiencing more things. Not this one. All of these?
I think just the number 2 is probably good, because it's, like, pretty general. See, that I actually don't care about. See, I don't care what form I take as long as I get to carry on. I just don't think that this counts as carrying on if it's not... I don't know. If it is what we've seen so far, then I guess it's still carrying on, because I feel like Carl definitely thought he was Carl.
Yeah.
That's still important, but the idea... But how Catherine is like, there might be another one of me roaming around somewhere. That's weird. Like, that's... I don't know. I guess we'll see how this game handles it.
I think this is what Simon would say.
I don't think Simon is sure enough of what's even going on. I think he'd want 4, because I think he doesn't care what he is right now. Otherwise, he'd be like, what is happening? He just wants out. He just wants to get away, right? Don't you think?
This one.
Yeah, sure.
Oh my gosh, how long is this? A life worth living?
Maybe we can find a new sense of meaning in this world. I like that one.
I'm gonna say no.
Yeah, I guess you'd say no.
I found a tracker homed in on the Ark.
Oh, that's clever. I wonder if I thought of that. Does it still work? I really need to know what happened to it. Please let it be safe.
Where are we? Oh, okay, I see. It's a proximity thing.
Yes. So we're near Australia.
I guess so.
I thought you were near China, because of all the Chinese writing. Huh. This is some hella good software. Find something from... planet to building.
Basically.
I found it. It's at a site named Tau.
Oh, no. It's on Earth. It's so close to Phi, they almost made it. Damn it, it won't make it for long in that state. A couple of decades at most. That's not much to build a future.
If we got to it, could we get on the Ark?
I suppose, but I'm not exactly flexible at the moment.
I don't know that I want to get on the Ark. I think I'd rather go out and find, you know, the people in the post-apocalyptic wasteland and just kind of chill with them. There's gotta be some people still alive, right? Maybe it's Fallout up there.
Maybe. Why can't I back out of this?
Maybe click out the computer? Yep.
I'll take us there. I can move, jump, swim, sort of.
Sort of?
Stuck in the door opener, the Omni tool. I'll just carry you there, and you'll show me what to do.
That sounds really risky. Besides, I don't like the idea of you carrying me around.
Come on, Catherine. This is what you wanted to do. Your final mission. Let's launch the Ark.
We would need to find a way to get into the Abyss. Can't take the climber without a power suit. We probably have to go to Theta and pray that Dunbat's still working.
Okay, so we go to Theta.
I don't know. It's pretty far.
Catherine, look around. What else is there to do?
Yeah, really?
Maybe there's
got
still
something
a
better
shuttle
to do?
Train that can take us to Theta.
I doubt it.
Just have a look around. Push comes to shove, I'll walk there.
Okay, then. I'll just eject from this thing. Don't forget to take me with you.
I won't forget.
All right, let's do this. Come pick me up.
Can I pull the Omni tool out?
Wait. Okay, just be sure to plug me in again at some point.
You got it.
Good luck, Simon.
Can she talk to us?
There's 2 of us in here now.
What do you mean? Oh, 2 AI? You got Jane and Captain?
It's a Halo quote.
Oh. Fine then.
Cortana as Chief's friendo.
You mean waifu? I'm scared. Also, I'm sure it's been 2 minutes. You want to get some food?
Sure.
I don't think it'll take us that long to eat, but...
No.
Just stop. So, what happened was Audacity crashed sort of in the middle of our last recording, and we went to this ship, and it was like an underwater ship, and whatever her face, Catherine or something, is that her name? Cassidy? Catherine? Carrie?
Maybe Catherine.
Whatever, she was like, we have found this other pod, we just need to blow up the ship so that it will be in an emergency state enough to escape. And then I guess we did that. We got chased around the whole ship by a strobe light head man, and that was pretty spooky, but we're not going to replay it because that would be boring. You're not here to see the latest techniques, right? You're not here to find the best walkthrough, so I don't think we're gonna miss out on all that much by missing that part, since I just told you what happened. It was cool, though. That was a cool setting.
It was.
An underwatery, with that guy following you, and you just kept staring at him even though she said don't stare at him.
I was trying to work around him. I was trying to get away.
But like, hey, what if he confronted you in that room and you stared straight at him? And you're like, I guess I'm dead.
Well, at that point I was dead. There was no way around him.
What if you just turn around and don't look at him?
I'm pretty sure he saw me and would chase me, but...
I'm just saying, there must be some kind of mechanic that has to do with not looking at him, right?
The longer you look at him, the worse you glitch out, possibly to the point of, like, death.
Is that what she means?
Maybe. That's how it worked in Amnesia. The longer you looked at monsters, you started to lose your sanity.
Interesting. I thought that it was more like, the more you looked at him, the more he could, like, hurt you. Like, if you didn't look at him, he couldn't hurt you. Like, he wasn't there. Like, it's like a mind game, like a reverse Stone Angels thing.
Hmm.
You know what I'm talking about? Like a Slender Man kind of thing? Like, you don't look at him, and then he doesn't.
Well, if you don't look at him, he still comes after you.
I'm just saying, I thought that maybe not looking at it was more than just a thingy. You know, guys wearing nail polish is a thing now. Check out Brian David Gilbert. Wears nail polish in all his videos.
I don't know if I'd like it, though.
Why not?
I wouldn't like having stuff all over my fingernails.
I mean, you don't notice it. It's not like makeup where, like, you scratch your face and then it comes up. It's just like... Well, that's why I like nail polish, and I like earrings, and I like tattoos. Because once you put them on, they're just there and you can forget about them.
We good to go?
What? Yeah, go for it, man.
I think I need some vacation soon.
Wait a minute, what the hell?
I speak papers about that.
Man, huh? this really picked up.
Yeah, where did that come from?
So that came up,
I don't remember
up,
that
like,
guy being a guy.
Right as you were leaving, I was messing with the...
Oh, I see.
Well, you like, left the room, and you know, you can play if you want to. I'm like, okay, I'll mess with the panel. I didn't think anything would happen, and then he started showing up behind me, so I paused it, and that's when we realized everything crashed. So I could like, go back a little bit.
No, this is interesting. I mean, I don't care.
Yeah? You put in a good word for me? I'm not sure that's a good thing.
Just listen to it first. I'm talking to them yet.
I'm just messing with you.
Who is that? He's like friendly. Now talk to him.
Hey, could you maybe help? I need to get the data.
Don't worry about it. I got this.
What? What? Is he talking to somebody else about you? Maybe his like dialogue is on a cycle, kind of?
You can really tell when Astrid is off platform. This place turns into such a locker room. Not in a good way, either.
I like that guy. He's cute.
I don't know, man. I just say we can keep things classy, even when women aren't around. You know?
Aw, I really like him. How nice. He's a nice guy. A really true
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah. You're so full of shit, Brandon. I've seen you when payload manager Alice Coster shows up.
I like that this guy's just like, living in his own little... His own memories.
You let her manage your payload? What? That doesn't even make sense. Come on. Stop messing around and get back to work.
It's so cute. I love it.
Forget it, Akers. I'm not playing with you anymore. As if chess wasn't boring enough. You just have to go and win in four moves or whatever.
He's amazing.
Yeah, I know. It's not technically a shield. Never mind. I found it.
Did you? Are they talking to each
Why
other?
Why would you want to go to Theta?
Is this like an R2-D2 C-3PO situation?
Might be a small fish in a big pond, you know?
I don't know.
Those little beeps are like...
I'm wondering why he's following him.
Tell you the truth, I fucking love my job. I love that Delta is such a tight operation. I get to try everything here.
Aw, he's so nice, and he loves his job. Aw, we gotta leave this guy alive as best.
Nice and easy.
He just loves his job. He just loves to be here. It's so sweet and pure. And he's respectful to women. What kind of a thing is he? Is he the same kind of robot? He's not the same kind of robot as the other one, right?
Yeah. It'll do.
I think so. It looks...
Because those red eye thingies.
He is, though. He's
careful,
like an underwater.
Nice and easy.
Different version.
Hey, can you hear me?
Help me out of here, will you?
With?
Got it.
I think he can't hear you.
Listen.
Don't stand there. You know better than that.
Hey, can you hear me?
Help me out of here, will you?
Okay, yeah, it's a loop.
I mean, you know, sometimes if you're happy, your delusion is better to live in.
Looks okay, right?
Words of advice from me. You know, we all have to fool ourselves, right? We all have to make it through the day with, like, a little bit of convincing ourselves something is different than it really is, so. Somebody's having a delusion and they're living that delusion and they're loving it, I say, you know, live and let live. As long as they're not, you know, hurting people, who am I to break their delusion? If they're like, unless the delusion is them, like, being attacked by spiders, in which case, then I'm having fun in that one, are they?
Looks okay, right?
Yeah, I was messing with this channel. I found, like, these different lines of, like, different channels. I activated one, and I guess it made him come up.
Interesting. Why did it make him come up?
It's not working.
I don't know. I'm not even sure what I'm trying to accomplish here. Like,
looks okay, right?
Yeah, I assume I'm supposed to pick the channel and then line up the spinny thing, but, like, I don't know what that does for me. Is it doing anything?
I don't know. Do you know what we're supposed to be doing right now? I forgot. We're going to Theta? We got out of that ship thing, but the thing went kablooey. And then that little guy let us out, right? Didn't he?
I think so.
And then he kept letting us into other stuff.
This is new.
Ooh, look at all that blood. This is scarier than... Ooh, what does that say? What's that stuff? Let's read it. The light burning my eyes. He's taking me. Don't need this something vicious? Viscous? Something flesh inside my skull to see salvation. I will gladly remove them. Stop them from obfuscating the divine illusion.
Wait, I can press it. Yeah, okay.
Oh, there it is. Vitreous. I don't know what that means. Like, so my eyes, I don't need this vitreous flesh. He is telling me I don't need this vitreous flesh inside my skull to see salvation. I will gladly remove them. So he took his eyeballs out or something? Like in that movie that I didn't think was scary, but it totally did. Oh my god, what is that movie called? Remember it was like the Hell spaceship?
Oh, Event Horizon.
Event Horizon, yeah. When that guy, the Jurassic Park guy, took out his own eyeballs. Because he was like, I don't need to see, I don't need them anymore if we're going to something.
When I try to open this bloody locker, it squishes. All we have in here, this is the chess.
Right.
Which wouldn't let me play it.
Reflection in the black, whatever. I mean, this guy's certainly a poet. We got a lot of poets working here, don't we?
A lot of smart people.
Not smart enough to save them from whatever the hell happened here, though. What are these pictures on the wall? Is this guy really into, like, anatomy or something?
I guess. Just took pictures out this window, like, yeah.
Like, you don't see enough anatomy outside your window. I feel like you'd have pictures of, like, a beach or a forest, but it's like, no, I need more. More sea life. You can't ever have enough sea life.
I think I did whatever I was supposed to do in there.
And we read the funky poetry. So. What is that up there? Is that the Flying Dutchman's ship? The ghost ship!
There's a ladder.
You're good! You're good! I said that to Dad recently, like, I was watching that episode, and he didn't know
really
what I was talking about, and I was like, how can you not know? Like, also look, there's a dead body.
Come in, Strasky. Can you hear me? Theta, listen. Akers is headed for Theta.
Don't tell me we're headed. Getting a signal, but no audio.
Strasky, it's Como Raby. Akers has gone mad. He's dangerous.
Which one is Akers?
Strasky!
Sorry, Delta. Still no audio. Try calling from another access point.
Strasky? I can try setting. I have pictures.
I wish I could remember the names of these characters. I feel like I only remember the names of the characters that are dead now. Amy and Carl, the only ones I remember. I
feel like that's the guy who, like, injected himself with the goop or whatever.
What guy who injected him? The one in the... that was playing chess?
Maybe.
The one that wrote on those walls, he was the crazy guy? Which one... but, like, which robot did he become?
I don't think he became a robot that we saw yet, unless that was him.
What? But who was the other guy? Who was that guy that was chill and who loved his job?
They didn't give him a name.
Didn't they?
No.
It seems like everybody has the name. Well, you gotta stick your fist in this, aren't you? Ew. See, look at that. It's like that black goop. It's like black sea goop.
Right.
You need to stop doing that. That is an addiction of some kind. Also, I don't think it did anything. I like that little guy's following you to help you out. Or spy on you, but either way, it's nice to have something. Ooh, a new toy. My earring fell out.
Is there a... can I see my objective? Show me what I want to... what I'm supposed to be doing, game.
I mean, we're trying to get to Theta, right? Theta. To Theta. Didn't he say that? To that guy, he said, I'm trying to get to Theta, can you help me?
Probably. I'm sure I missed that. Okay, so...
good thing you have me there. Here. So
this is where I need to go. Here. Okay.
This dude is pretty styling, from what I can tell, by the way. At least, you know. If we die, we'll die. We'll die stylish. And that's all you can really ask for in this world, you know?
Yeah.
I think that's what James Dean said. Die young and leave a pretty corpse. Or maybe that was somebody else. Or maybe James Dean actually never said that, and people just said that because he died young, and they didn't want people to be sad.
Oh, this is...
this is where we came out, right?
Okay,
this is
so we went by here.
And we're trying to get to Theta. So we just gotta go to that... I don't know.
It said Theta. It said, like, Zeppelin Transport Theta, but there was nothing there.
What do you mean there was nothing there?
It's just another sea bear circle. Okay, so this sign says Zeppelin Transport Theta, and this is where it takes me.
Maybe we can, like, hold on to that little guy's little wings, and he'll just, like, fly us there. Oh, this thing that makes your vision glitch out. It's that guy again, that goopy man. I bet that's the guy. I bet that's the guy that was playing chess. Don't you think?
Probably.
Because that's how you end up like that, right? You play chess. Playing chess makes you crazy!
This is what chess does to you.
Yeah. They look like organic something.
I guess they're like the Techno Goop or whatever it is.
Techno Goop. That's my DJ name.
Techno Goop in the house.
Exactly. I just only do EDM, you know? Play Coachella. It's my dream. Yeah, I don't know where... Should I look it up? Do you want me to look it up?
Sure. At this point, I don't care.
Okay. Let me talk.
Sorry.
Your little robot buddy will accompany you around this area. If a door is stuck, he will automatically crack it open for you with this deep sea welder. I like this. I just like that they called him your little robot buddy, which is very useful when exploring the whole area. There's a ton of useful information hidden throughout the site. It is highly recommended that you explore every building site in Delta before continuing with the main objective. I think we kind of did.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Below is a small map to help you find your way around, blah, 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 blah. When you're ready to continue with the mission, head over to the comm antenna. The first thing you must do is interact with the antenna controls. These are the three lines on the left side of the screen that are color-coded.
Okay, so I have to go back there.
If you are colorblind, the one pointing at 10 o'clock is green, the one pointing at 1 o'clock is yellow, and the one pointing at 6 o'clock is red.
So right where I started when we started the game is where I should be.
Yeah. Press the button to the left of the screen to turn it on, then select the Zeppelin's menu to call up, in parentheses, Echo, and request a transport. So I guess we set it and forget it?
So which one did it say?
Let me read it again here. You must move the cone around this map using the arrow keys on the screen until it lands on one of these lines, then click one of the eight channels on the right side of the screen. So okay. Literally anything, I guess?
I did.
Got it.
Okay.
This one even corresponds to that one. If I click two, the green one lights up.
It says once a link is established on the antenna screen, you will be able to make calls to that Zeppelin on the screen at the landing platform. So it's a different screen.
Okay, so I do want to be at the Sea Bear Circle.
Yes.
There was a panel there then that I didn't see.
Also, you'll just be safe from sea bears, which is always a good idea.
Always
there's another guy.
Yeah, I can't.
Maybe that's the guy. I guess you can't interact with him. I hope that wish this little robot buddy would follow us forever, but it seems like he won't, because otherwise the thing wouldn't say that he only followed you around this area. Oh, there! What's that? Is that it? That's it, totally it. Zeppelins! Zeppelins! Woo! What happened?
I got it working.
The Zeppelin's on its way. Better get
how?
Ready.
How?
I got the right channel and got the one that was actually functional.
Interesting. Well, I guess now we just wait in the seabird circle. No, it's kind of a... Whoa! How can I make a noise like that underwater?
Sound travels better underwater than it does in air.
Like does it?
Like
does
seven
it
times
really?
Faster, I think.
Well, then, aren't you smart? Look at that thing. That's wild.
Unspecified cargo.
That's troubling. Now get up there! Run! Get up on it! Oh, you are the unspecified cargo. I thought that was gonna open up and there's gonna be something terrible.
Calm down, we're safe.
Oh, it's really disconcerting popping in and out of existence like that. Where are we now?
Delta.
Cute.
At least that's what you said before the crash.
Oh, right. Of course, is this a Zeppelin?
Appropriately named. You think it can get us to Theta?
It's a cargo transport. They use them for moving materials between the sites, anything that's too big for the shuttles. I'm sure it can carry us.
Okay, that's all you needed to say. You didn't need to give me that history lesson.
Come on. Oh, the tool chip is bust.
Isn't that part of the Omni tool?
Look who's been paying attention.
I had to deal with that back at Upsilon.
Then you know how it works. We need to get a new tool chip and switch it.
Can you point me in the direction of the closest tool chip storage?
I think it would be easier to just take one from a robot.
What? Just knock a robot over the head and steal their chips?
The toolbox over there says it has a stun baton. You could use that.
Come on. I don't want to hurt anyone. Isn't this a bit much?
It's just a robot, Simon.
We're just robots. Sort of. I'll get us a chip.
Yeah, geez. I like how Simon like also knows that he's a robot now. Like he's just cool with it. Oh, I like Simon.
Guess I have no choice.
Okay, hold on. Before I do anything else, there's a row of, like, deactivated buddy bots.
Does Catherine have, like, a vendetta against other robots? I don't get it.
I don't think so. I feel like she wants me to get him over there, but I'm not gonna get him yet.
Oh, man, I bet they want you to get the nice one.
That's what I'm saying. I think they want me to get him.
That's terrible. Don't do that. If you can help it.
I'm going back.
Is this really just a robot torturing game? I swear to God, I swan to John.
I don't remember it being a robot torturing game. I remember Carl getting tortured. I just didn't remember any of the robots being tortured. Oh, it's a Ray. I didn't remember.
Steal its chip!
Yeah, there's like a bunch of this guy, but like deactivated.
Yeah, I remember. They're around. They're like around. I don't know. I wish Catherine would just point us to the storage, because stop being a bitch, Catherine. Those robots are... Simon's right. Simon is right. Listen to Simon. He's nice.
They're
he has a good heart.
We are.
Yeah, exactly. I love that Simon said that, too. Like, he said what we were thinking instead of just us having to accept. I like Simon. He's a nice guy.
Where?
Yeah, we'll that's a stun
around.
Baton?
Apparently.
He's holding it like a gun.
Come on, when do I take it out? I take it out around robots, so maybe I actually don't have to.
Don't have to what? Use it?
Maybe.
I don't know. The way that the game is set up, it's for him and him saying, like, I have no choice, it could sound like you're gonna have to do it. But I think we should try to find one without hurting anyone first.
Should be over here. Here it is.
Because otherwise, why would Simon even say that, right? Why would he even say, is there not another option, if there wasn't another option?
Can you take your tool chip?
Why won't it let you get the tool? They've got to be in there. This is really upsetting. I'm gonna look that up. I'm gonna see if there's something better we can do.
Buddy. Oh yeah, no, it'll let me do it from Buddy. I'm not gonna do it to Buddy, but let me do it from Buddy.
Let me figure it out. It just says that you're supposed to get one from the one talking to itself. Grab a stun gun from the case and search around the contents of the talking robot. Shock him a few times and like crashes into the floor. Remove his tool chip and take it back to your Omni tool. Why would I do that? I guess you have to.
Like, why am I get, like, if I get a prompt for that?
Don't do it. Don't do it to him if you don't have to. He's also helped you, by the way. So even if you could choose,
I don't want to do it to him. I don't want to do it to anybody.
I'm just saying I would worry that you would do it to him and then it wouldn't actually work. Like you wouldn't get anything from it and you would just have hurt your buddy. You know. I think we have to get it from the guy talking to himself because Catherine is a bitch.
Of course you do.
Why does Catherine want to hurt fellow robots? It's not very nice, Catherine.
I feel like Simon gave in too easily there. I feel like he had a solid argument and then stopped.
Right. He loves his job. Although, I don't know if this will actually even be a problem. Like, it might hurt him, but don't you think he'll come back online and, like, just keep chilling?
Maybe. I gotta do it.
Looks okay, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Uh-oh, is he gonna fight you?
Is he? I don't think so. Do it again?
Yeah, you have to do it a bunch of times.
Oh, I'm hurting him.
Oh. Man. Let me ask. Let me ask. I mean, you kind of already got him going down.
Guys? I need help.
Oh. Oh. I should have looked up something different before. Hold on, you need to pause it. Without hurt... I can't spell. Hurting bots. Can I pass this level? Ugh. Ugh. It's even worse than I think. So... we do have to kill this thingy, but also, if you kill the talking robot, the little robot will shy away from you and makes upsetting slash panicked beeping noises, and then afterward refuses to come near you again and will not let you come close to it either. And then it says, this game fucked me up, man.
So one way or the other little buddy isn't going to help us anymore.
No, but the little buddy is intelligent, so don't hurt him.
Well, yeah.
Because also, I mean, he's also our friend. But man, I don't want to hurt him. It makes me so sad.
Should we not play this?
Let me look more. Hold on. Everybody in the comments are like saying the same thing we are. They're like, this decision is making me hate my life. So another one, I don't have the chess computers and spinning radio thing. I looked into it for 10 minutes before it just zapped the looking instruction bar. It also made me sad because the sleek guy didn't want to be near me after I did it. Which is weird since Catherine mentions that K8's are dumb as rock and Catherine is shady AF. Maybe we should play a different game. I don't know, we've already started it. I'm gonna... hold on. Actually, this looks like something that was written by us. Let me read this. Yeah, this looks like something that you and I wrote together. This is a very well done and intriguing game. Sadly, I am stuck in Delta as I refuse to use a stun gun on any robot knowing what I know in the context of the game. Sorry, I am not your bitch and I simply won't finish the game and I will never buy a frictional product again unless an alternate course of action is given. If there is already an alternate, I can find it, have looked hard enough, and it is not posted on the internet yet, but obviously disregard this message. This is no possible reason other than making the player your bitch not to offer an alternate. And there are people being like, it's just a game, blah, blah, blah.
Well, the whole point is to make you feel things.
I know, the whole point is to make you feel bad. But they like, people are like, yeah, being stupid about it, but this person is, I think, in the right. But, they say, after a little while, they're like, sorry, I was hoping somebody had an alternate course of action at this point in the game. Sadly, they do not. When you make a thoughtful game, thoughtful people are going to play it. They get upset when you force them to violate their moral code for a stupid junk item. If you want to look at a similar compelling game that doesn't violate the player, see The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. Maybe we should play that. Technically, I guess I would be classified as a hater in this particular case, but my hate is directed at an extremely specific aspect and situation of the game because the developers go out of their way to force me to break my moral code all for a stupid disposable item that they could have placed elsewhere. Frictional really had three choices at this point in the game. One, do exactly as they did. Two, allow the player an alternate choice of action for attaining an item. Or three, give the player a choice to ending them on their own terms, preferably in a satisfying way. Given choice two or three, I wouldn't be posting here. The test tells more about the tester than the testee. Game deleted, future games from Frictional ignored, sad, so much promise. And then she's just replying to other stuff. I think it's a she, I don't know, could be a dude. So just, I mean, it's cool that people are actually discussing this in the first place.
Yeah, it's good. No, so it's because the people are...
yeah, like, it's the kind of conversation that I would want to have. This is a matter of faith, not in God, but Frictional as a developer. I see their mastery and potential as a developer. Otherwise, why would I bother posting here? But I felt manipulated in Soma, not by the story of the situation, but by Frictional itself. It brings me absolutely out of the game when this happens. It is something devs should strive to avoid. I agree. I mean, also, especially if, like, I don't know. Especially as Simon, who says, isn't there something better we can do? You know? If you're gonna make me... yeah, like, it seems like to even offer, to even say there is another option, like...
the game goes out of your way
to make you feel bad about it.
To make you feel bad about it.
And also, like, what's at stake? Like, we don't actually know what we're... If it was like this is a very minor thing, but killing a robot is...
Faster.
The fastest way, and the thing that we're trying to get to is very important, I'd be like, okay, but the fact that we basically are just moving throughout the whole game, just
kind of... It's
important
to her, and he's just kind of on board, too.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but you know, yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? Like, if it was like, this is about my survival, and I can't, you know, it's me or him, that'd be one thing, but we don't even know what we're fighting for, really. You know what I mean? Like, we're in this new world, we're just speculating that going to this arc thing is going to be good. We don't have faith in it like Catherine does. And even if we did, we shouldn't have to be forced to do this.
And also, it's just a robot. She's the one who's like, don't let my appearance fool you. I was human once. It's like, excuse me?
I mean, Simon said it. He said, we're just robots. Like, I'm curious what's happening, what's going to happen, but I don't want to keep doing this if...
If that's all this game is just continuously doing that with scary stuff between.
I don't know. Do you think it gets better? Do you remember?
I know the ending's sad.
It is?
It's like,
Spoil it for me.
So there's a concept in this game that hasn't actually shown up yet. Is like the coin toss, they call it, where like to move forward, you copy your mind into another body, but you don't transfer it, you copy it.
Yeah, I know.
So like...
It's not actually your consciousness, it's a new consciousness based on yours.
But here's the thing, you do that to progress in this. There's a point where you switch into the body, you leave your other you. You just leave him. Like he's just gone. Like, by other me, I'm going to move forward now.
I mean, it's fucked up, but I get it. Like, I get it. Like, I get it.
And then when they get on the arc...
It's like your children.
In the arc, there's this tense, like, come on, like, get me in there before it launches. And it does it just in time, but it launches and you're still there. Because you're the you that didn't go on there.
Well, that's fucked up.
You're the copy who didn't get to go on the arc. You and Catherine. Like, there's a version of both of you on there... But they actually show you after that. They show you, like, hey, be like, we made it. After that, they show that. It's like, okay, you really screwed with me here.
The yous that you leave behind, are they alive? Or are they, like,
you dying? I only remember it happening once where, like, you switch to a better suit or, like, a different suit that's, like, more for, I don't know. But, like, yeah, like, you're still there. Like the other you is, like, still there. Like, well, huh.
Yeah, that's... High key fucked up. Let's play a different game. Do you want to start a new one right now? Just because I feel like this has soured me so much.
Sure, fuck it.
Let's start something like what's the thing that you like that you would like to comment on, that you would like to play and comment on. We could play.
Oh god, it's even worse too because I'm okay.
Tell me, no, I want to know. I want more validation that stopping playing this was a good idea.
So Simon gets like mad at her. As a result of that, she's like, we lost the coin toss. It's going to happen. Always going to happen. She's like, I can't believe you didn't tell me. And then she gets like mad at him. Like, what did you expect? You were stupid. And then like, that like shorts her out or something.
And
she's
dies.
Just quiet. And that's it. She's like, he's like, Catherine. And then like, it goes to the other version.
So we don't even know what the hell happened to, how did Simon get there in the first place? How did Simon's consciousness get put into this weird machine?
Oh, that wasn't explained, was it? They, like, in the very beginning, they scanned his brain. That was the copy. That was, I guess, that was their thesis or, like, their special experiment or whatever. They were copying, a version of his consciousness. And admittedly, I don't remember
how... The guy with the brain tumor? So did real Simon die in the real world? He went on with his life and died?
I think this is hundreds of years later.
I'm saying this Simon is not... Is that Simon, the guy we played at the beginning, took off the helmet and went about his day?
Yes.
And then we're playing as copied Simon in the future?
Yeah, we're playing as copied Simon in the future. From there to now, just boom.
Honestly, I would, again, this is not what I would do at all. I'd be like, Catherine, get me to the damn surface. I don't want to get in this stupid arc. Now we're gonna go see if anybody else is alive, and if they're not, then I'll kill myself. But I want to see for sure. And she would be like, I want to get to the arc. And I'd be like, fuck you, Catherine. I'll go alone then, bitch. I'll take my own little robot buddy. We're gonna go find civilization. That is what I would do. I would have no interest in this arc because I understand the coin toss concept. That's what she was saying. Like, it's weird to think there's another version of me running around. Like, I get that. But...
Also, fun fact, she's dead. Her co-workers killed her. The real her? Her co-workers killed her.
Why?
I
was
don't
she being a...
remember. I think there was some dispute about something. I forget. But, like, they totally, like, beat her to death or something. And, like, she finds it. She's like, they killed me?
I mean...
My friends?
She sounds like a bitch. I don't know. All, what I'm saying is, though, is I would know, I think I would know that I would not get put into the arc, because that's, like, the concept that everybody else was, understanding, right? When you're, like, taking that test, like, they know that they are not getting put into there, but they're, like, it's like your child, right? Like, it's like giving your, but yeah, if I were Simon, I would also forget that, because I would think I want to live, you know?
Also, there's something that's kind of depressing about knowing that the arc will eventually fail.
Will it?
I mean, it's a satellite. It's like a computerized world in a satellite orbiting, like, I guess to be fair, like, it runs on solar power, so, like, it could go on forever, but, like, that stuff will wear out eventually.
Also, living forever is a scary concept. I mean, I like the idea of living forever, but not like that.
It's also, like, what if not everybody wants to be in a world like that? It's just kind of,
well,
like,
I think they had the choice in the beginning.
I think that's true.
They could either accept death or send someone on. I think I would send my consciousness on, but I wouldn't, like, trust it. I'd be like, good luck, little me. And my little me would be like, you bitch! I don't like this! And I'd be like, well, sucks to be you.
I trusted me.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would think long and hard about it, probably. But yeah, if I were Simon in this game, it would not be about getting through the arc. It would be about getting to the circle. Because clearly clearly this world is still inhabitable. We're under the ocean, right? We're still hanging out under the ocean. Even Amy was still alive, doing something. There must be people. Right? Don't you think?
Maybe. I think that's why we're still alive, because we're down here.
But this is what I'm saying, is that if there are people alive down here, who knows where else people are, like, in bunkers or in whatever. You know what I mean?
There's always a chance that there's someone, and with our new robot body, we can go wherever the hell we want.
Yeah, maybe other people did the same thing, and now we just have, like, we'll meet other people. Or we just hang out forever in this, place. Like, maybe, man, we could have saved Amy, and we could have, like, sort of the planet, although I guess if I'm a robot, you probably can't impregnate Amy.
You have to find some dude.
Exactly, we're looking for Amy's true love. That should be the game. We save Amy, and then we look for her true love, and we repopulate the Earth.
To restart the human race.
Yes, exactly. Now that this comet or whatever, something happened. Because this is, like, definitely, because Simon just kind of accepts it. So what story is being told here? Is this about Simon's trusting, the fact that he's so trusting and it just gets him screwed over all the time?
Maybe.
Is that the moral of this story?
I think it's just kind of like, I don't know, maybe it's a cautionary tale against the tampering of, like don't do that, or just like, I
don't mess,
like,
with the concept, God's domain.
The concept of copying your consciousness into something, it's like it's you, but it's not you. Like, there's always gonna be another one of you. Like, that's what you do,
I guess. But that's like,
also the goop we've been seeing, the black stuff, that's like some sort of miracle. And that's been interesting. That's some sort of space magic goop that, like,
it's like our lamp, like City Miracle ink.
Kind of. It makes technology work. Like, it fixes things. It connects things.
That's
makes
the key to the
work.
Future. You got to bring some of that shit up with you. Put it on some machines. Build a terrarium. Restart humanity.
Yeah. There's a whole bunch of, like, stuff in this game that's just, like...
So my guess is, like, Simon... I'm trying to figure out what the hell the story is even supposed to be. Like...
Like, what's the moral of this? What is it trying to tell us?
Yeah, like one of my favorite... What did I watch? I watched Barnyard again. Remember that movie?
Yeah.
Where all the male cows had udders?
Yeah, for some reason.
Because they... Well, I think it's just because otherwise kids would be confused, I guess. But it's, like, has one of my favorite tropes, which is the reason that I love Rango... Which is the idea of somebody realizing that what they want is not relevant. It's what their family wants, you know? And then they like, learn to be, again, a leader or a hero or whatever. And I love that kind of story. What kind of story is this? Or, like, Event Horizon, right? They all go up. They mess around with God's domain and blah, blah, blah. Everyone gets messed up. Point is, don't venture out into space. That's bad. That's the message, I guess. You know, they went on a terrible adventure. They stuck their noses where they shouldn't have. That's the kind of story that it is. But what is Soma?
Amnesia is kind of redemption. Do you mind if I spoil Amnesia?
No, go for it.
So Amnesia... Because
games have stories too. I'm mentioning movies, but games are also telling stories.
Amnesia is like, there's messed up stuff in that too, but it all already happened. Like, it's called Amnesia because your character made himself forget. Like, you start out, you're like, I know my name is Daniel, that's all I know. Because you did, like, awful, horrible things that you couldn't live with anymore, and made yourself forget that, but also, like, had to stop the guy you were working for. Is like, the point of that. Like, you did...
Yeah, it sounds like redemption.
Like, this whole thing where, like, the more pain a person is put through, the more, like, I think it's called Vitae, I don't know, some, like magic thing that'll help this other guy get back to his, like, other dimension or whatever the fuck he's from. But, like, that, like, as a result, like that means putting people through a ton of pain, like, finding the worst ways to torture people.
That's fucked up.
Exactly, which is why he made himself forget. He's like, I can't believe I did all these
horrible
things.
I mean, that's
things.
Amazing, though. That's, like, that is a... That's that like a, is
that's like
narrative.
A redemption arc.
Because, like, but what has Simon done? What has he done that he needs to be punished for? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
this
what
is
the...
what you get for dying.
Yeah, like, I don't get it. What is the story? Like, what is the story?
I don't know what the
I
story
feel like this
is.
Could have been Catherine's story, but it's not. Like if we saw it from her perspective, maybe it could be, like, about her pushing away people in her life, and then at the end she's, like, alone.
That'd
like,
be a cool level transition. Like, oh god, where am I now?
But, like, you know what I mean? Like, imagine, like, Simon... Imagine, like, they go through all this and learn the perspective of Catherine, and then Simon puts his consciousness into the arc, but he's, like... But he dies or something, right? And then she's alone. And she has to deal with the fact that she's alone now.
Yeah, that's a good point. Like, what is... Like, what... Like...
And she's, like, she thought she would be okay with it, but she's totally not.
I think it's just... You know, I don't...
And that would be, like, a hubris kind of...
I think it's just supposed to be, like, one of those stories where it's like, oh, what does it really mean to be human? Like...
Well, like, there's no real answer to that, is there?
No.
But I think that would be cool if it was Catherine. Like, because it makes sense that all of her coworkers killed her. She was on the pursuit of this, like, this thing, and she didn't realize that she cared. Like, and at the end, she realizes that it's not actually going to... That it doesn't, like, give her the fulfillment that she thought it would. And since she sent Simon and her consciousness in there, like, Simon did make it in there somehow. I don't know, not, like, the whole shebang he made it in, and she didn't, and she's just, like... But she knew that was always going to happen, but now she's, like, empty at the end. Like, you could see that this was the pursuit of something you don't understand. I feel like that would be an interesting story. But what is Simon... This poor guy! This poor, poor guy with a brain tumor...
He didn't...
Whose wife, like...
He wasn't supposed to be here. No one, brought him here. It was an accident. He wasn't meant to be here. It was,
and what,
like,
the hell happened with his girlfriend? I don't get it. What was the point of that stuff?
That's actually a really good point. I have absolutely no idea what relevance his girlfriend
had. We never,
had
like,
this.
Learn that? Because he had, like, a nice life, at least. I mean, he had his, like, his girlfriend was, you know, dead, and he had a terrible thing, but, like, he had a job that he seemed to like, and he had friends.
I totally forgot about her. Like, I forgot about... That's the thing, too, like...
Well, I was wondering when she would come up. Like, what is her relevance?
Like, it'd be one thing if he just had a girlfriend. Like, that would be more interesting, too. If he just had this girlfriend, and then she's, like, she's just among the people who are gone.
Yeah, that would be totally... That would make a lot of sense.
Like, it's not just like he has a normal life, and now he's here. It's like he had something, like, impact
him as a
person.
Yeah, something crazy is happening.
That
and then,
apparently has no bar on, like, what's happening now. Like,
maybe,
okay, thanks.
You don't think that it happened and you just didn't, like, notice it or something?
I just forgot that
I'm
going to
look that up. What is...
I totally forgot that she...
Existed.
That he had a girlfriend.
Yeah,
and
but,
that she,
like,
died.
I just remember, like... Because I thought that was, like, a mystery that was going to be revealed. Hold on. Soma... Oh, I can't spell words. Soma...
Also...
Girl.
Since I know what happens, I might actually finish this game myself then.
Why?
Just do it. Also, I think there are, like, big fish monsters that come after you at some point later. I think that does happen, and that's, like...
I mean, it sounds cool, but not cool enough to...
I might just watch Markiplier
play
it
again. ...to deal with this. I mean, you could... I would not be opposed to you playing this. I just feel like I don't want to... I don't like... It's not that I dislike bad endings. One of my favorite movies ever is Ex Machina. It's so good. I don't care what anybody says. If anyone wants to debate me in the comments, you can just kiss my ass, because it's really good. And you can't convince me it's not. It is good. It's very, very good. It's an artistic masterpiece of a movie, and it's so hard to watch. It's awesome. But that has a really... Spoiler alert, that has a bad ending. But, like, it's one of my favorite movies. But it makes sense. Like, it all works out. It's everybody's... Like, there's, like, three different people whose stories come to an end that way. And it's really cool. But, like... I don't need an ending to be happy. I just need it to make sense. Like, or not even make sense, but be satisfying. It says, Athena, after Simon is hurt and caught by proxy, Terry Akers, Simon seems to hallucinate that he was back in his apartment in Toronto where Ashley appears and attempts to confront... Comfort Simon. Simon's confusion regarding her presence prompts her to ask if he no longer wants her. Simon clarifies that he does indeed, but asks... her what happened. She proclaims that they fell in love, but then Simon regained consciousness as he hears a loud sound. So, that doesn't answer why she was asking. She was saying, don't make this weird.
Hmm.
So the passengers see the car driven by Simon when in the intersection of Bloor Street and Badena Road, the vehicle was hit by an SUV whose driver was distracted by her children. While the mother and children were left bruised but unharmed, Ashley died from suffocation due to blood filling her lungs. Yeah, this sucks. Let's play something else. So anyway, guys, thanks for listening to our... thanks for watching our awesome gameplay of Soma. I mean, I think we had...
Thanks for listening to our plot debate podcast.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Not debate, but something.
Our discussion, our
discussion of plots of things.
Our discussion salon, our...
Whether they're good, what they mean, if they mean anything, and what the point of this...
But this is what you're here for. You're here for our thoughts, right? Otherwise, you could watch literally anybody play Soma. You could watch Markiplier play Soma. I'm sure he's a lot more willing to stab robots than we are for his viewers.
Probably. Again, I think he did leave Carl to suffer. I think he, like walked away wide, like, no one here. Like.
Well, I mean, you know, Markiplier plays games for a living.
Yeah.
We don't have to do that kind of crap.
No. And we don't.
And we won't.
I guess this is it for Soma.
Yeah, see you. Thanks for watching.
All right,
bye. Bitch.
Sorry. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea. Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, dig in the earth and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The new play, the flute, the cop play, the hop, the plays play, the bass and the sound, the chop, the bass play, the brass, the chub play, the tub. The flute is the duke of soul. Yeah. The way he